Hey everyone, welcome to Judging for the Win. I'm Dave, and this is my daily ruling. Today's question was suggested by a viewer. Thanks to Joshua Allen for this one. Amy controls Lynde, Cheerful Tormentor, and her curse of leeches is destroyed. What happens? Okay, so this is a pretty straightforward question. Even though Curse of Leeches is a double-faced card, when it's in the graveyard, it only has the characteristics of its front face. And that means that the game is going to see that a curse got destroyed, and so therefore it's going to get put back onto the battlefield, attached to you, just like any other curse would while you have Lynde out. Okay, so that wasn't super interesting or unexpected. What would happen if we had the Curse of Leeches transformed into a Leeching Lurker before this happened? Would that change anything? And the answer is yeah, it would. If you have a Leeching Lurker that gets destroyed, then the Lynde is actually not going to trigger at all. And the reason is because Lynde has a special type of triggered ability. This is a Leaves the Battlefield trigger, and that means that it's going to trigger based on the game state immediately before the trigger event happens, rather than immediately after, which is what normal triggered abilities do. And so, when the game looks and sees whether this triggered ability should trigger, it's going to see that even though there is a curse that got put into a graveyard, the thing that left the battlefield was not a curse. It was just a normal Leeching Lurker, and so therefore the ability is going to not see that its trigger condition was met, and there's not going to be any triggering at all. And well, okay, that's kind of a bummer. I really wish there was some kind of a card that had a curse on the back half and a normal card on the front. Okay, now we're in business. This is where things are going to get really interesting. We'll start with the case where we have the Accursed Witch dying, and that's going to be pretty much the same as what we normally would expect. There isn't going to be any triggered ability from Lynde for the exact same reason. Immediately before the trigger event happened, we just had a normal creature and not a curse, and so that would mean that absolutely nothing special is going to happen with Lynde, and you're not going to get any Lynde trigger. You will, of course, get the Accursed Witch's trigger from its own ability, but, of course, that's not going to work any different from how it normally would. Now, the really spicy tech happens if you were to have an Infectious Curse that got destroyed while you controlled Lynde. What would happen then? And so, if the game takes a look to see if this triggered ability should trigger, now we're going to see something really interesting. Even though in the graveyard we have the Accursed Witch, which is on the front face, not a curse, we saw when the curse left the battlefield that it was indeed an aura curse, and that means that we're going to have a trigger from Lynde. So that's going to be pretty interesting to resolve, right? I mean, what's going to actually happen? Well, fortunately, we are actually going to be able to find this card in your graveyard. Even though its characteristics have changed, it doesn't even have the same name, but that's not a problem. The game still knows that this is the same permanent that got put into a graveyard and caused Lynde's ability to trigger, and so therefore it can find it and it will be able to return it to the battlefield. Now, when it tries to do that, there's going to be a couple of complications. First of all, if you have a double-faced card, you only can put it onto the battlefield transformed if the effect specifically says that that's what it's doing. Of course, Lynde's ability doesn't say anything of the sort, so that means it's going to enter the battlefield with its front face up. In other words, it's going to enter the battlefield as an Accursed Witch. Now, that's kind of interesting because it leads us to our second little complication. Accursed Witch isn't an aura, so it's not normally going to be possible for it to be attached to anything. So we fortunately have a rule that covers this case as well. Anytime the game tries to put something that isn't normally able to get attached to things onto the battlefield attached to something, then the game is just going to put it onto the battlefield and it's not going to be attached to anything. So what's going to happen is, after this card dies, then the game is going to see that triggered ability is going to trigger, and it's going to return the Accursed Witch to the battlefield on its front face up, and it's not going to be attached to anything. Pretty cool trick, and definitely got some really interesting interactions in there. One more thing before I sign off. If you're going to TCGCon this weekend, I'll be there also. I'm the head judge of their big modern event, so if you're in the area, stop by the Magic area and say hi. I'd love to meet a fan. But that's all I have for you today. How did you do? Join me again tomorrow for another daily ruling, but until then, I hope you have a great day.